Lakhnavi suit, and that was my only prized possession. And I had a third hand cycle which looked pale yellow, which my elder brother used, then my middle brother used, and then I was using. But I was on time for the audition. I went to meet Girish Karnad, and the elite class of Pune was there. All these girls who looked beautiful, fair, who had car, who had kinetic Honda were there. And I was all excited that we are getting to meet Girish Karnad. So I enter, I park my cycle properly, and I enter this beautiful wada of Rajabhavan Atu. And we were looking at each other, there was an awkward silence, and I don't want to name, because you all might know that lady, but she's someone's mother. So she looked at me and she said, "Are, why have you come?" So I got a little nervous and I said, "Girish Karnad is going to meet some new fresh faces or something like that." She said, "Yeah, but you haven't seen your face in the mirror. Dark girls don't look nice on screen." And I was like, please, I want to die at this very moment. I was so embarrassed, and she said variety of other things also. But it was probably meeting Girish Karnad which lightened up my mood, because I decided to be a waiter that evening, because I said there is, you know, I probably am not worthy of even meeting him. So let me just help Rajabhavan Atu's wife and serve pohe and chaha. So I was helping him, but then the girls were made to stand in line, and Girish uncle started talking to us. And then he asked me, "What are you doing? What is your name? What are you doing?" And I said, "I'm working on a play, which is by Khanolkar." And Girish Karnad spared that moment, you know, and he said, "Khanolkar also is known as Aarti Prabhu, na, as a poet." And I said, "Yes, you know him?" He said, "Yeah, I have worked on Ek Shunya Bajirao." And I couldn't believe a person like Girish Karnad is talking to me, and I never ever dreamt of working in films. I never ever dreamt of anything else in my life. I was happy doing theatre, but it was Girish uncle who selected me for that movie, because I was probably looking perfectly poor.
Rohit, please share with us what made you decide to take to cinema.
Actually, I don't remember the day when I decided. I was an assistant director at the age of 16.
Okay.
And I directed my first film when I was 23, 24.
Oh, but yeah. There must be some point at which you must have
seen. I think because of the home atmosphere. My dad was an action director, he was an actor, my mom was a stunt artist. So maybe because of that, it was always like I want to be in films. Either I'll be in action or I'll be doing something in films. And that's what happened. I became a director. I do action myself. So both my dreams came through. When I was small, like how you were narrating, when I was 6 years old and I was very ill. So my mom took me to a family doctor. We used to stay in Santa Cruz. And while coming back, the us zamane mein gaadi breakdown ho jati thi. So the car was not working. Something happened. My driver said that we can't go. And suddenly my mom saw a bus coming. So she said, "Yeah, chalo bus mein chalte." That was the first time I entered a bus. So tab se mera thoda money minded tha. I was sitting and I think that I saw the conductor counting notes. I told my mom I want to be a conductor. Itna paisa milta hai isme. But I always wanted to be in films, and yeah. Coming back to your book, I read the book and it's really nostalgic, you know. And because when we are the same 80s kid, and by the way, you all must have not read the book. People used to cheer up by when Hero was released. Because her name is Janu, and there was a song in the film, "Tu Mera Janu Hai." All the boys, when she used to cross the lane, they used to sing, "Tu Meri Janu Hai." So, congratulations. And it's definitely, you know, I wasn't double man, I should confess, like whether should we make a series out of it, like a Nukkad or something. It's that good. It's simple, it's engaging, and it's like, today it's like when you read this book, when you all read this book, it makes you feel like life was so simple. We used to go to each other's house to give wedding cards or Diwali cards or meet each other. Now we message Happy Diwali.
Yeah.
So life was really good then. Like I was coming from Andhra. Sorry, I was a bit late. Actually, I left at 3:58 exactly, but I reached now. So in the car, it was 3:58. You see the whole of Varli changing, you know, it's like, it's so nostalgic when you take the ceiling and you come till here. It's like the whole world has changed totally, and you miss that what we call in Hindi the sadgi of Mumbai.
Yeah.
What is there in this book?
Yeah. Thank you so much, Paro. Would you like to share some?
So, I mean, I of course speak of documentary films, and I don't know, it's a strange decision to come to, and I can't remember also how I did it. But the thing is, I came from a family that was like perfectly divided into one very professional type of must study. There were CAs and engineers and doctors. And then my mother's family was a film family, because my grandfather was a well-known music director, my grandmother was an actress, and she became a producer. So for me, it was like a divided life of coming for summer holidays to Bombay to my nanny's house. Then consuming stardust.
Yeah.
You know, holiday homework done. Watching TV endlessly, and people are always singing, and there's always some like laugh in the house, and there are actors around, and this was normal. Raat ke 3 baje sona. You know, this kind of non-disciplined life.
Yeah.
And I would go back after holidays and study in convent school and be told that,
yeah,
oh, you're not going to be like your cousin, just get married and all that, you're going to be a professional woman. So I think when I grew up, it was also difficult, right? I'm not an 80s kid, I'm a 70s kid, I'm the oldest person on this table. So when I started working, I mean, when I went to college, a lot of it was default. I didn't like what was on offer, but I don't think it was really a possibility for somebody like me to work in movie films at that time. It was like beyond contemplation. And so I think when I started making documentaries, it was more like, okay, I can't do all of that, and I want to work in films. I don't want to be a writer, because everybody said to be a writer, and I was like, I won't know what other people think. So I chose this really obscure thing to be a documentary film. But I think, but eventually, when I made my own films, that divided self was there, right? Like all the pleasure of movies, having songs in my films, or making this kind of masala documentary, which I make now, and sometimes people would get, in the early days, people would be like, you're destroying the seriousness of documentary by doing all this, right? And acting in my own films as a goddess or whatever.
Yeah.
All of it came from actually that childhood of non-stop pleasure.
Yeah.
I don't know, when I was a kid, it was kind of, people didn't admit that they're watching me films.
Yeah.
It was totally uncool.
Yeah.
Right? You only listen to English music, supposedly.
Yeah.
But I grew up playing Antakshari.
Yeah.
So I was like, how do I admit that I'm fine? So it's been that kind of a secret life that found its way into my work.
Actually, even today, when you know, there are me and my husband have this thing on Zee Cinema, they play all these, you know, trashy films, and you know, we have this 1 second this thing within 1 second, I guess which film it is. And I have really seen all those rubbish films. It's like I can guess each and every, and then you know, sometimes they say maybe it could be this film, but maybe it could be that, because that has the same star cast. And some films are actually made like a formula, you know, same people, same set, same this thing, and they just change the character names, and they just kept making films. And we consume so much of cinema at the time. And I think that's a good cue to do the video chapter, because the other excerpt that I'm going to read is from the time that we had a video, the VCR come home, and how the VCR changed the lives of children of my generation. And like,
there's a film called Safed Hathi.
Yes, I have seen.
There's a song of Zahamara, Safed Hathi. And the dog, I don't know how many are familiar with that. Actually, that Wonder the dog,
Brownie
Modi poster laga tha uska. Jackie Shroff was chota, and that dog was big. In Tere Meherbani. And that film was a blockbuster.
Yeah, I know, it was a super hit.
Super hit film.
Paro, would you like to share some video experiences?
So, you know, my family was one of those rare families that had their own
video.
Oh! Your mind is echoing. I think my mind is echoing. I've got that kind of special mind. Double like, well, okay.
Is that less echoing?
Yeah.
So, my family had a VCR pretty early on, because my dad was posted in Iraq. So,
okay.
We had a VCR, but there was no access to VHS cassettes. So the only films that we had were Shaan and Love Story with Kumar Gaurav.
Okay.
So I have seen both these movies at least 300 times. Right? Like I know all the dialogues of Shakal and whatever. So when we came back to India, of course we would have many people coming to our house to watch these films. But when we were in Iraq, it was interesting because we had Pakistani neighbors. And they knew more about Hindi films than we knew, in a way. And it also became a big thing for us to bond on. The thing to do was, like, we somehow koi jata tha Kuwait ya Dubai, and they would bring back a tape of some film, right? And then we would watch that film, and then we would stop it where the songs were. We would tape the songs onto an audio cassette from the VHS because we couldn't access all of that, and then listen to the songs over and over again. And also practice the dance moves from the films, right? We would stop it, then we would practice the dance moves. So I think, like, I didn't have the rent all night VCR experience. Yeah. I remember that my cousins used to do it. I think most of all it was that thing that, otherwise, you know, films were elusive, because if your favorite song came on radio and you were not home at that time, it was gone. And you waited in Chitrahar and or Chayaki, as it was called in Bombay.
Yeah.
The worst thing that could happen to you was that the last song would be Nanna Munna Raiyu.
Yeah.
And it's a very long song. That means the moment that song came, you know, like, okay, it's me, or Ganna Nahi Aane Wala. It's a limited pleasure that you had before. Ki chun chun ke da, chin chin ke le rahe ho ye pleasure. Suddenly, VCR made it unlimited. Oh. You could immerse yourself in that pleasure. And I guess that's my big memory of VCRs.
Rohit? You seem to be a complete video person. You know, looking at your.
Only not the VCR, you know, that change, LP recorders are the pehle bade gramophones. So we had that at our place, and bachpan se tha that I've been filmed. So we were doing a play, a skit, more than an annual day play. So I was somewhat like to from a very well to do family types, Shetty ka beta types. Haan. So we were doing that famous scene of we were given that famous scene ke kitne aadmi the.
Okay.
So technically I was like, I have to do something different. So I said ke, and Sholay was the first film which jiske dialogues be out with the like song, you know. So on that LP recorder there were dialogues also. So I said to my teacher that we will play this and we'll sing it, so it will be like different from everyone. We did the rehearsals and all, and on the day of annual, my principal is sitting, everyone is sitting, all the ex-students, students. And then came our turn and we started with that thing. Everybody is singing and everybody was in an awe. You know, kitne aadmi the? He said, teen. Aadmi teen, aur goli chhe. Kitni nainsafi. And wo na atak jata tha. To wo chhe goli ne, wo 40 goliyan chal gayi. And I didn't know where to run. You know, I don't know kitne logo ko pata, wo atakta tha kabhi. Then you have to do that tichki. So fir aage badhta tha. To wo atak gaya udhar. I still remember that. When you were saying, I was going on my school day, that kitni goli, wo 40 goli chali hai. Wo uske baad kabhi mereko mauka nahi mila koi direct karne ka, seedha film mili. But VCR again, like as you said, was like an event. We used to hire and whole night, as you said, we used to see films, and I think that was a learning experience. And that was a phase, like as you said, that the history goes like why films were made so trashy is because of the VCR generation. People were not going to theatres. Theatres were being like demolished, and a lot of big theatres came down and because of the VCR, and everybody used to say that films nahi banengi, and you know, and then came that phase of South Indian movies making films in Hindi, Himmat Wala, all those films, Justice Chaudhary. So I think the whole memory is like we learned from there, and somewhere, and that's why like today because of Netflix and Amazon you see so many films, but those were the days in VCR in one night, because of VCR wala khada rata tha, we used to see 4-5 films in a day. So that's been a learning experience also in a way.
When I see your films, I see a lot of the action and the comedy that you do. That the escapism of the 80s, I see that a lot in the way your films are way more stylish and way more this thing. But you know that love for film and love for cinema and the way a film buff makes a film, that shows in your films so much. All the references and the visual references you have. I just and that's the reason actually I thought that this would be a that's the reason I thought of you to launch this book.
Oh, I thought because of the name you thought.
I just want to ask a question to Anuji also. He's sitting here. I didn't the reason he's not part of the Q&A right now is because I didn't, we had not prepared the questions and everything. But I would just like to say, you were a very popular music director.
Trying to move around and meet producers, and to take up from where Rohit sir said about his family, I've said, and it led me to his father.
Okay.
And that was Shetty uncle when he was picturizing a scene at Mehboob Studios for if I'm not wrong, it was either Prakash Bhaira or Manmohan Desai, someone.
They were the only two people who were making films.
So at that point of time, when I went there and I saw him, I was completely, you know, scared of him. As everyone else, I didn't want to go in front of him. But strangely, when I went up to him and I said, "Sir, hello, I took my father's name," he smiled and he offered me a cup of chai. And that was huge for me, and I still remember that moment. He made me sit down and I said, "I want to work." And he went on telling me a lot of things about how you can get work. So I said, how do I get work? Idhar aate raho, milte raho, sabko dekhte raho, kabhi na kabhi kaam milega. So for me, that was a very important moment in my life. And I mean, when you remember your father, obviously for me, it's a great thing that I met your dad. And when, you know what, मेरी फिल्म में जो कुत्ता है वो बहुत बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट कैरेक्टर है और वो तेरे को मुखड़े में लेके आना पड़ेगा. तो मैं बोला मुखड़े में कैसे लाऊं सर. बोला लेके आ, तू कुछ भी करके लेके आ, मैं हूज गोना राइट द सॉन्ग. सो ऐसा सर आपका मुखड़ा है, बड़ा मुखड़ा. बोला देख कैसे होते, उस जमाने में क्या होता ना कि अंग्रेज लोग और बर्मा शैल वहाँ ना वहाँ नहाने को देते नहीं स्विमिंग पूल में. अरे मैं मनमोजी गली में जाए और अमित एकदम ना घोड़ा गाड़ी लेके घुसने वाला है उसके अंदर. तो ऐसा ना बड़ा मुखड़ा सर. वॉट मर्द टांग क्या मारेगा, मेरे दोस्त है ऊपर वाला. सो ही दैट वाज बिग क्लैप एंड दैट वाज माय मुखड़ा. एंड देन सुन भाई मोती, द डॉग्स नेम वाज मोती. सो दोस डेज इफ यू गॉट ऑल दिस कैरेक्टर्स इन द सॉन्ग इट रियली वर्क. एंड गेस व्हाट, द फिल्म बिकेम अ सुपर हिट आल्सो. दैट वाज द फर्स्ट बिग हिट फॉर देम. सो फॉर मी दोस मोमेंट्स आर ह्यूज. एंड वन मोर थिंग, व्हेन यू से हाउ डू यू ग्रो अप इन द 80s, व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट द वीडियोस एंड द VCRs एंड एवरीथिंग, आई रिमेंबर शेट्टी एंगल से जो बात हो रही थी. सो ही सेड थोड़ा ना परसेप्शन चेंज करना चाहिए जिंदगी में, लगना चाहिए स्टाइल वाइल. तो आई सेड ओके, हाउ डू वी गो अबाउट इट. सर जब तुम रिकॉर्डिंग पर रहेगा लगना नहीं चाहिए ना, यू नो, चल के आया, बस से आया, ये इंडस्ट्री में सब नहीं चलता है. तो ऐसे मैं क्या करूँ, मेरे पास पैसा नहीं है. वी टॉकिंग अबाउट द 80s, राइट. सो आई रिमेंबर कैचिंग अ ट्रेन टू बांद्रा स्टेशन एंड देन walking all the way near the McDonald's. Huh. I remember was a man with Gazebo. We used to call it McDonald's. Because we used to go there. Why? Because Mr. Ramesh Behel used to have Chinese food there. So we used to stand outside. Ke kabhi kaam mil jaye, Panjab na ko chhod ke mujhe le le. So we used to stand with the harmonium there. But there I remember catching a cab, because that was my first recording in Mehboob Studios. I took a cab and I said, "Bhai sahab, यहाँ से 5 मिनट तक है, लगना चाहिए कि आदमी कंपोजर आया है वहाँ." तो बोला कोई बात नहीं साहब, हम आपके साथ हैं. एंड आई टुक अ कैब राइट एट द कॉर्नर नियर सलमान साहब हाउस. टुक अ कैब एंड द कैब वाज गुड एंड ही केम आउट एंड ओपन द डोर. साहब कहाँ से आए हैं, दैट वाज ऑल डिस्टॉर्टिंग क्लैप. फॉर मी दिस इज द 80s एंड गॉड ब्लेस यू, यू आर टेकिंग मी बैक इन योर टाइम. गॉड ब्लेस यू.
थैंक यू. सो नाउ यू वांट टू शेयर योर नाइट्स, बिकॉज़ द VCR रेंटिंग वाज so popular then, and we used to know during Ganesh festival that we would have cultural evenings, and we would sustain through the cultural evenings only because the last day was VCR night. So I still remember a play where it was based on Santa Jnaneshwar. So Jnaneshwar had three siblings, his elder brother, younger brother, and his sister Muktabai. So I was Muktabai and there were three other brothers, and there is a episode in Jnaneshwar lives where in his life where he you know tula mandey athavtat ka, that episode where he, you know, he magically prepares kind of chapatis. So chapatis were already made, and that was thalipit was made, which is very tasty. So the kaku who was preparing our play knew that we want to do is to eat thalipit and to watch the VCR, to wait till VCR night. The play was on and I was doing that thalipit which was already ready, and Nivruti started eating, other brother started eating, and Jnaneshwar, who was seated and who was magically making the chapati, he was looking all the time at those thalipits. And the entire scene was not moving because kids were eating thalipit. Jnaneshwar was waiting for his turn. Finally, Kaku came on stage and she gave one chapat to all of us. She told my brother who was playing, "Jnaneshwar, tuja thevla yaad madhe, I kept one for you inside, get up now."
And that is how the scene ended, and we were now then welcome to the VCR night. And I remember watching fantastic movies like Sagar, Ek Dooje Ke Liye. I remember crying profusely, and my mother was so angry at me for watching that film and going to my neighbor to watch that film. And I remember a petrifying film called Maafi Sa Sakshidar, which was based on Joshi Abhyankar. Do you remember?
Yes.
That was pretty popular then. So I saw that film and I was so scared of sunsets. I realized that films are very powerful medium then, because I always thought they tell fun stories, because during our summer holidays we were always taken to films where the films were based on circus or probably Charlie Chaplin films, which were lighter, which had some humor, and we were too young to understand that this is black humor, this is beyond fun. We wouldn't understand that, but Maafi Sa Sakshidar was a turning point in my life, because I realized that there is fear, there is threat, there is terror. And much
That's
later,
a very chilling film. Yeah.
It is, and much later I realized that was only a film, which was canned as a very realistic film. So
That way, Ankush was once shown at the Ganesh screening on the street, and we watched it as kids. I don't know, parental guidance kuch tha hi nahi. And that film scared me so much. Like, that film is so it really scarred me. And I felt, and now I feel ki kaise, how did they put it in the public like that? Yeah, it was such a serious and very realistic film. But yeah, I know what you mean. So, should we wrap some question answers?
For you, probably. You should answer. The audience can ask some questions.
I would like to also,
she's here now.
Abhilasha is the one, this lovely illustrator done by my sister-in-law Abhilasha, who's really, really talented and a lot of a perfectionist. And she's gotten the gist of the writing and the flavor and the tone of the writing so well. And she's become a real partner in the way we've delivered the work. And she's here specially for this evening to see the launch. And I told her that when you get compliments for your work, you should be here to receive them in person. You should not hear them from me. So I'm very happy that she's been able to.
Thank you.
Do you want me to answer that question? No, I just felt that I had to move on. Actually, entertainment journalism had stopped being satisfying in the age of digital journalism, where there's only, you just follow trending stories, names that work, hashtags that work, and it was slightly getting less satisfying to do what I was doing at the time, and I thought that it was time to move to doing something more interesting. I've always wanted to influence people to tell good stories, and I felt that maybe in the days of viral content marketing, where content plays such a big role, I could make a difference by doing something else, and something that engaged me in intellectually, actually, which film journalism was sadly not being able to. So that's the reason I say.
I have a question.
Yeah.
The chapters that I read, I think one of the things that really struck me was the kind of Bombay that felt very familiar, and now you don't see around so much. And the hallmark of it was, you're talking to the dhobi. First of all, your parents had left.
Yeah.
Locked up in the house, and the dhobi is babysitting you from the window.
Yeah.
And he himself is full of so much bunkers
style.
And I was thinking, like, if you could talk about that a bit. Like, I always associate that street swag with Bombay, that language, and everybody is cool.
Yeah.
So could you talk about that?
So she's talking about a chapter called The Three Musketeers.
Can you read just the first half of that chapter? That
okay. My three musketeers, Baban Kaka, Damu Kaka, and Jagan Kaka.
I've lived it at the age of 16. I've gone through it with all the great Manmohan Desais and Prakash Bairath and of course Shetty sir. And what a memory I have. So when you took the name of Mithunda and I said Julie, because that is a song which was, I was entering the 80s, 81-82 and Mithun Das suggested teri awaaz bahut achhi hai. I don't want anybody. I said, Dada, main khali composer hun. Nahi, tu hi gaega. And by the way, Mithun Das launched me as a singer. So in the 80s, Rohit sir, in the days of remixes, this is one song which is dangerously fantastic. Humko meri nahi maangta, sung by me. Humko meri nahi maangta, humko Lily nahi maangta, humko Sandra from Bandra nahi maangta. Hey, to kaun maangta? Hey, Julie, Julie. Johnny ka dil tum pe aaya, Julie. Tere liye chad jaun suli. Tu hi to meri jaan hai, jaan hai, jaan hai, jaan hai. Hey, Julie, Julie. Johnny ka dil tum pe aaya, Julie. Tere liye chad jaun suli. Tu hi to meri jaan hai. The girl says, humko Tony nahi maangta, humko Peter nahi maangta, humko cycle wala Michael nahi maangta. And I come and say, hey, to kaun maangta? Oof, Johnny, Johnny. Julie ka dil tum pe aaya, Johnny. Tumko hi maana maine apna honey. Tu hi to meri jaan hai. And that's how it ends here.
My mom would like to
Marathi tunas bolte
acha ha pustak prakashanacha sohla atishay uttam ritya sadar zala tumhi saglyani enjoy kela ani tine mala kai tari ga mhanu sangitla pan ह्या सगळ्या सोहळ्यात बाकी काही गाण्यापेक्षा मी म्हटलं मी पसायदान गाते आणि आता सोनालीताईंनी ज्ञानेश्वरांची आठवण काढलेलीच आहे तर मी एक दोन श्लोक म्हणते त्यातले आता विश्वात्मके देवे येणे वाक्यज्ञे तोषावे तोषो निमज द्यावे पसाय दान हे जे खळांची व्यंकटी सांडो तया सत्कर्मे रति वाढो भूता परस्परे जडो मैत्र जीवाचे दुरितांचे तिमिर जाओ विश्व स्वधर्म सूर्य पाहो जो जे वांछील तो ते लाहो प्राणी जात थँक्स
अच्छा जानी मैम आप बिग बिग कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस आज रोहित सर भी आए हैं आपको कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करने कैसा फील हो रहा है थोड़ा बुक क्या
गुड थिंग इज दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल कैन रिलेट टू इट सो इट्स अ वे टू शेयर चाइल्डहुड मेमोरीज एंड आई होप द बुक मेक्स पीपल शेयर देयर चाइल्डहुड्स एंड अदर स्टोरीज विथ ईच अदर एंड मेक्स पीपल मीट मोर ईच अदर विच इज द पर्पज ऑफ द बुक एंड आई एम वेरी ग्लैड दैट ही इज कम ही इज नॉट ओनली कम बट ही इज नॉट कम एज अ सेलिब्रिटी गेस्ट ही सैट ही हर्ड ऑल द स्टोरीज ही शेयर्ड सम ऑफ हिज ओन स्टोरीज and I think it's very gracious and generous of him to be
here. Janvi and we go a long way. जैसे अभी आप सवाल कर रहे थे जानवी ने कई सवाल किया है मुझसे कई सालों तक एंड सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ है जो बुक लिखी गई है इट्स लाइक यू नो एक अलग वर्ल्ड में आपको लेके जाती है और जो वर्ल्ड में आप जाते हो वो वर्ल्ड में आप जाने के बाद आपको एक सुकून मिलता है आपको खुशी होती है एंड साथ ही साथ यू रियलाइज़ कि ये वर्ल्ड रियल था कभी जिसमें आप जिए हो आपका बचपन गुजरा है एंड इट मेक्स यू थिंक यू नो जब मैंने ये बुक पढ़ी जब जानवी ने मुझे ये बुक दी कुछ दिनों पहले एंड इट मेक्स यू थिंक कि हम लोग वी हैव यू नो हम वी बीन एडवांस इन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड बहुत कुछ हो गया है, बट कहीं ना कहीं वो एक सिंप्लिसिटी, एक सादगी जो थी हमारे शहर की या हम सब में, वो कहीं ना कहीं मिस हो रही है. वो कहीं ना कहीं हम बहुत ज़्यादा सब भाग रहे हैं, इंक्लूडिंग मी. एंड बट जिंदगी तब भी चल रही थी, जिंदगी आज भी चल रही है, बट कहीं ना कहीं जो सिंप्लिसिटी थी वो ख़त्म होती जा रही है. एंड हर चीज़ को कहीं ना कहीं हम ज़्यादा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कर रहे हैं फॉर नो रीज़न. यू नो, कुछ चीज़ें जो पहले बहुत ही सिंपल और सीधे तरीके से जी जाती थी, आज वही सारी चीज़ों को कॉम्प्लिकेट किया जा रहा है. हमारा माहौल भी ऐसा हो रहा है कि हम यू नो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हो जाती हैं चीज़ें. सो जब व्हेन यू गो थ्रू दिस बुक, एक कहीं ना कहीं पीस ऑफ माइंड मिलता है. इट्स लाइक अ मेडिटेटिव थिंग यू आर डूइंग. यू नो, दो द बुक इज़ ऑन यू नो हर लाइफ एंड हर चाइल्डहुड, बट इट्स लाइक यू फील हैप्पी वंस यू फिनिश द बुक, और यू इवन इफ व्हेन यू फिनिश अ चैप्टर यू फील हैप्पी एंड यू रियलाइज कि या ऐसे तो थे हम लोग, अब क्या हो गया हमें. अभी यार एक नाम लूंगा ना तो फिर दूसरी बुरा मान जाएंगी, और किसी जिसका नाम लूंगा ना वो ऑफिस कल आ जाएगी, तो बहुत टेंशन हो जाता है आजकल. मैंने बोला ना, बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हो गया है सब. हाँ, गोलमाल मतलब जैसे मैं को जब भी कोई अब गोलमाल के बारे में पूछता है तो ऐसे अब वो ड्यूटी लगती है कि मैं औरों के लिए बना रहा हूँ, ऑडियंस के लिए बना रहा हूँ. वो मेरा प्रोडक्ट नहीं रहा, हाउस होल्ड ब्रांड बन गया है. आई हैव टू जस्ट मेक इट एवरी नाउ एंड देन एंड ब्रिंग इट टू देम. एंड कहीं ना कहीं जैसे गोलमाल भी अगर आप देखें तो मैं जो कैरेक्टर्स की बात कर रहा हूँ, मतलब वो सादगी वाली चीज़ है. मतलब यू हैप्पी ऐसे ज़्यादा हर चीज़ में, यू डोंट नीड टू क्वेश्चन एवरीथिंग, यू डोंट नीड टू एनालाइज एवरीथिंग. कभी कभी सिर्फ खुश रहना भी सेहत के लिए अच्छा होता है, तो गोलमाल वही काम करती है. अभी बहुत नेक्स्ट ईयर आएगी. थैंक यू.